The James Webb Telescope was manufactured to discover the impossible, and its latest discovery has proven that it's actually achieving what it was expected of it. James Webb has allowed us to see the end of space by discovering the oldest galaxy. The previously oldest known galaxy was discovered by Hubble in July and is known as GNZ-11, which dates back 400 million years after the birth of the universe. And it's not even been a year since James Webb hit its orbit, but it's breaking all the barriers in space research. And not only that, it has already surpassed records by its predecessors. But finding the end of the galaxy is another level of accomplishment. But how was it able to make it there? Hey folks, hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I have decided to talk about the recent discovery made by the James Webb Space Telescope as part of its space adventures. So if you want to know everything about the latest discovered galaxy, make sure to stick through to the end of the video. Also, please spare a moment to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated with the latest videos from our channel. With that being said, let's get started. First things first, before we dig into the latest discovery, let us first get a glimpse of the background of the James Webb Space Telescope. Webb, to date, is the most complex telescope ever built and reached its final destination around gravitational special spot in space known as the second Lagrange point, or L2, this year. On January 24th, it fired a set of thrusters and pushed itself into orbit around this point, which it will circle once every 6 months or so. To understand its exact position, L2 is on the opposite side of the Earth from the Sun, about 1.5 million kilometers away, or 4 times the distance to the Moon. Here, the gravitational pull of the Sun and Earth equals the centripetal force required for Webb to move with them. James Webb reaching here, in its own sense, an achievement, because only a few space missions have made it to L2. The 110 billion telescopes took the internet by storm, just with their first few images, and have continued to do so to date. Very recently, the telescope has allowed space scientists to explore the oldest known galaxy, the Jade's GS-Z13-0. Light doesn't travel infinitely fast. That is why when we see objects from across the universe, we're actually looking back in time, as they were when their light left them. It's important to note that the light of distant galaxies travels across billions of years of space and time, and in doing so, it has shifted towards the red end of the electromagnetic spectrum. And astronomers have this system of denoting the amount of redshift symbolized by the letter Z. The higher the redshifts, the further away the object will be, because it means that the wavelength of light has been stretched more by the universe's expansion. GNZ-11 has a redshift of about 10.975. The farthest galaxies we knew before James Webb came into the picture were GNZ-11 and HD1. So here you see that the Z represents the redshift, and from GNZ-11's name, it's clear that its redshift was a factor, or Z, of 11. According to scientists, it existed when the universe was about 400 million years old. The HD1, on the other hand, was discovered in April, but kept the record for just a few months. After that, James Webb discovered glass Z13, which is said to have existed some 30 million years before HD1. With the discovery of the glass Z13, it appeared that it was the oldest galaxy ever known. James O'Donohue, a planetary scientist, astronomer, and science communicator, previously at NASA, took to Twitter to explain more about this distant discovery. He tweeted, "The Sun didn't even exist when the galaxy glass Z13 appeared as it does above. In fact, it wasn't to exist for another 9 billion years." He added, "When glass Z13 emitted the light we see today, it was about 3 billion light years away from us, or whatever us was back then. The 3 billion light years of space that once separated us from glass Z13 has expanded to over 33 billion light years today." But all these metrics are about a static universe. In actuality, the light took over 13.4 billion years because space behind it kept expanding. However, the age of glass Z13 is confirmed by the gold standard of distance measurements, and that raised a lot of doubts about it. That's not where the story ends. In fact, James Webb continued its mission to reach the other side of space, and as part of the JADES, or James Webb Advanced Deep Extragalactic Survey, by the UK University of Hertfordshire, Dr. Emma Curtis-Lake and colleagues, James Webb led to the discovery of JADES GS-Z13-0. The latest discovery was published on the reprint server at ARXIV and uses the gold standard approach of spectroscopy to confirm the distance of galaxy candidates. According to the results, galaxy JADES GS-Z13-0 was captured by Webb as it was 325 million years after the Big Bang. But before we get into the details of jades, it's important to understand why scientists are relying more on gold standard spectroscopy if they can get reasonably good estimates of redshift by applying specific filters to their cameras. It's because the redshift technique, also known as photometry, was used to estimate the redshift of both glass Z13 and Sears 93316, does not give you an accurate measurement. For instance, suppose there is a lot of dust in or around a galaxy. Now the photometry will make an object look further away than it really is, giving false results. On the other hand, spectroscopy splits the light up into its compound parts and allows astronomers to accurately determine which wavelengths are coming from stars in the galaxy and which are coming from dust. According to official records, the Jade Galaxy is estimated to be 33 billion light years from Earth due to the expansion of the universe since the light has just reached James Webb, left the galaxy. All thanks to Webb's powerful near-infrared spectrometer, or NIRSPEC, developed by the European Space Agency, which has made it possible for us to get spectroscopic analysis of Jade's GS-Z13 and many other space stations. Talking about this discovery, the ESA's senior scientific advisor, Professor Mike McCaffrey, said, "This is what James Webb was built to do, and the European-built NIRSPEC instrument lies at the heart of it. The search for the first light in the universe needs a large cold space telescope and a sensitive infrared camera to identify things that might be faint galaxies forming just a few hundred million years after the Big Bang." He further explained that, "But there's a lot of hay and not many needles, so you have to look at many candidates, smearing out the tiny amount of light from each one into a spectrum and using the telltale tracers to see if there are any right distances and age. By being able to efficiently examine hundreds of targets at a time, NIRSPEC brings that kind of cosmic magnet to the haystack." On the bottom line, we can see that James Webb has started a new era of advancements in the era of space. With the discovery of the oldest galaxy, and paradoxically the youngest because the universe itself was very young, just a few hundred million years after the Big Bang, this galaxy was young and one of the first galaxies to form. The telescope has set the bar high for future ventures. This marks the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell icon as you enter or leave. This will only take a microsecond, but will significantly boost the YouTube algorithm, propelling our videos to the top. See you in the following video.